Thinking about getting a nose job? Thank goodness it's not the 16th century. Turns out, people actually got nose jobs in 16th century Europe, but they weren't due to vanity. They were because of two major causes of nose loss. The first was swords. It wasn't completely uncommon to lose your nose in a duel. In fact, Tycho Brahe, the 16th century astronomer, lost his nose in a dispute over a mathematical formula. For the rest of his life, he wore a brass nose. The second cause was syphilis. The disease was a big problem in 16th century Europe, and in its later stages, it can cause these tumor-like growths called gummas. When they form on the nose, they can eat away at the healthy flesh and basically just leave a rotting mass of tissue on your face. In order to replace all these lost noses, these two brothers in Italy came up with an early form of rhinoplasty. The process went a little something like this. They would make two incisions on your bicep, slide a knife under the skin between the incisions, and then shove some fabric or cloth under the skin flap they'd created. They would leave the fabric there for about 3 weeks to make sure the skin didn't reattach to the muscle, at which point they would cut off one end of the flap and sew it onto your face. You'd basically have to walk around with your head attached to your bicep for about 2 weeks. Then they would cut off the other end of the flap, mold the whole thing into a nose-like shape, and sew that onto your face as well. That all sounds horrifying enough, but remember, this was 16th century Europe. There were no antibiotics, there were no good antiseptics, so basically, it was quite possible that you would die of sepsis because of your nose job. On top of that, there was no anesthesia, so you were awake for this entire process. So if you don't like your nose, or you have syphilis, be thankful you live in the 21st century. Ew. Hi, Anna from Nova's Gross Science here. If you have a gross science idea, please leave it in the comment section below the video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.